Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 50 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show, selected especially for public television.
Hello, I'm Mary Lou Metzger, your host for this Lawrence Welk Show. This episode... was taped in 1978 and features the songs of Perry Como. We'll hear well-known Perry Como hits including Catch a Falling Star, Don't Let the Stars Get in Your Eyes, and It's Impossible. And later in this program, I'll visit with Sheila and Sherry Aldridge, the Aldridge sisters. But now, let's start off the show with Hot Diggity.
Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? It's so new to me. What you do to me? Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? When you're holding me tight.
Gentlemen, next we have the newest member of our musical family. The brothers and sisters recall a Como recording of 1958.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Love may come and tap you on the shoulder some starless night. And just in case you feel you want to hold her, you've got a pocket full of starlight.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Aldridge sisters and the Otwell twins. You know, folks, Lawrence tells me we've had the greatest audience reaction to these youngsters of any new people we've ever added to our show, and we're so happy for them. Perry Como is known primarily as a ballad singer, but he does a wonderful job on all kinds of songs. Here's an example as Bobby and Sissy return to their childhood days.
¶¶ loves mambo.
Mama loves mambo.
Look at him sway with it, getting so gay with it, shouting no lane with it, wow. Papa loves mambo. Mama loves mambo. Papa does great with it, swells like a gate with it, and loses his weight with it, now.
He goes too.
She goes fro.
He goes fast.
She goes slow.
He goes left.
She goes right.
Papa's looking for Mama, but Mama is nowhere in sight. Papa loves Mambo. Mama loves Mambo.
Mama loves Mambo.
Having their fling again, younger than spring again, feeling that zing again, wow.
Oh, Papa loves Mambo.
Mama loves Mambo. Don't play the rumba and don't play the samba, 'cause Papa loves Mambo tonight. Don't play the rumba and don't play the samba, 'cause Papa loves Mambo tonight.
You know, I'm so glad we're doing this particular show because Perry Como has been, without a doubt, my favorite singer since I was a little girl. And being from the younger generation, I've chosen one of his more recent hits. It's impossible, tell the sun to leave the sky. Just impossible. It's impossible. Ask a baby not to cry. It's just impossible. Can I hold you closer to me and not feel you going through me? Split the second that I never think of you. Oh, how impossible. Can the ocean keep from rushing to the shore? It's just impossible. If I had you, could I ever want for more? It's just impossible.
Thank you.
two great artists. And speaking of twosomes, here we have Guy and Rona with one of their favorite Coma songs.
If they made me a king, I'd be but a slave to you. If I had everything, I'd still be a slave to you. If I ruled the night, stars and moon so bright, still I plead to you. If my friends were a crowd, I'd turn in my need to you. If I ruled the earth, what would life be worth?
the show, and here's a song that was a big recording hit for Perry in 56. It also happens to be one of Jimmy Roberts' top requests. Come in, Jimmy.
More than the greatest love the world has known, this is the love I give to you. Alone. More than the simple words I try to say, I only live to love you more each day. More than you'll ever know, my arms long to hold you, so my life will be in your. Waking, sleeping, laughing, weeping, longer than always is a long, long time. But far beyond forever, you'll be mine. I know I never lived before, and my heart is very sure. No one else could love you more. Longer than always is a long, long time. But far beyond forever,
Folks, I know I can't sing like Perry Como. After all, who can? But there's one area I may have just a little bit of an edge on him.
How many have seen Perry dance?
Fellas, how about giving me a lead in to Perry Como's 1957 hit song?
You must have a favorite Perry Como song.
Yes, sir, I sure do. And this was another million seller for Perry.
And I love you so. The people ask me how I've lived till now. I tell them I don't know. I guess they understand how lonely life has been, but life began again the day you took my hand. And yes, I know how lonely life can be. The shadows follow me. And you love me too. Your thoughts are just for me. You set my spirit free. I'm happy that you do. The book of life is blue, and once a page is read, all but love is dead. That is my belief. Yes, I know how
Tom Netherton is so great on that Perry Como hit. Stay tuned for Ken Dilo singing Prisoner of Love and a rousing Myron Florin rendition of Hoop-Dee-Doo. At the end of this program, I'll visit with Sheila and Sherry Aldridge, the Aldridge sisters. Now, let's return to the songs of Perry Como.
For an example of Perry's great versatility, we're bringing you a country song that he made very popular back in 1952. And for this, we call on our country gal, Ava Barber, just back from a very successful concert tour of Germany.
Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night. In daylight, it dies. Don't let the stars around too long. Don't forget where you belong. When the stars come out forever, you'll be mine. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night. In daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Keep your love for me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love. Too many nights, too many stars, too many moons could change your mind. If your love is gone, don't forget where you belong. 'Cause without you in the sunshine, you'll be mine. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Stars get in your eyes. Keep your love for me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love. Too many nights, too many stars, too many moons could change your mind. If your love is gone, don't forget where you belong. 'Cause without you in the sunshine, you'll be mine. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night. In daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Keep your love for me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's a holy. When the world makes you shine like you've got too much wine, that's a holy. Bells will ring a ting a ling a ling a ting a ling a ling, and you sing a vita bella.
Vita bella.
Hearts will play tippy tippy tay, tippy tippy tay, like a gay tarantella.
Tarantella.
When the stars are making you drool, just like pasta fazzuola, that's amore.
That's amore.
When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love.
You're in love.
When you walk in a dream, why you find you no dream is signore.
Signore.
Scusa me, my, you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore. When the stars make you drool just like pasta fazzuola, that's amore.
That's amore.
When you dance on the street with a cloud under your feet, you're in love.
You're in love.
When you walk in a dream, my, you find that you're not dreaming, signore.
Signore.
Scusa me, my, you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Thank you. too weak to break the chains that bind me. I need no shackles to remind me. I'm just a prisoner of love. For one command I stand and wait now. From one who's master of my fate now. I can't escape, for it's too late now. I'm just a prisoner of love. What's the good of my caring if someone is sharing those arms with me? I don't care how she is. I can't have another, for awake or sleeping, upon my knees to her I'm creeping. My very life is in her keeping. I'm just a prisoner of love. I'm just a prisoner.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and thank you, Johnny Zell, too. You know, most folks, when they watch a Lawrence Welk show, they kind of expect a polka, and we just happen to have a polka that was a big recording hit for Perry Como, the very popular Hoop-Dee-Doo. So back to the pizzeria with me. Wild, don't they? As you know, the Perry Como show had a special feature called We Get Letters. And at that time, Mr. C would sing with his very fine guitar man, Tony Mottola. And now, with the help of our very fine guitar man, Neil Levang, I'd like to sing a Gordon Jenkins song that Perry recorded, This Is All I Ask.
As I approach the prime of my life, I find I have the time of my life. Learning to enjoy at my leisure all the simple pleasures and so I happily concede. This is all I ask, this is all I need. Beautiful girl, walk a little slower when you walk by me. Lingering sunrise, stay a little longer. Children everywhere, when you shoot at Batman, shoot at me. Take me to that strange enchanted land. Grown-ups seldom understand wandering rainbows. Leave a bit of color for my heart to own. Stars in the sky, make my wish come true before the night has flown, and let the music play. And I will stay younger, yes, I will stay younger, yes, I will stay younger than spring.
Many fine qualities is his strong sense of religion. I've always enjoyed the familiar hymns on Perry's TV shows. Here's one of his personal favorites with Norma Simmer and our men's choir.
Oh,
We hope you've enjoyed these wonderful songs of Perry Como. And I know you're going to enjoy our very special guests. These two beautiful sisters joined the Lawrence Welk musical family back in 1977. Please welcome Sheila and Sherry, the Aldridge sisters.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Mary.
Thanks, Mary.
So good to see you.
So great good to be here with you.
Now, you were living in Knoxville, Tennessee, when you joined the Lawrence Welk show, but you're really North Carolina girls.
That's true.
That's true. I was
born in Avery County.
Yeah, Avery County, North Carolina, but I was born in Marion, and Sheila was born in Spruce Pine, North Carolina. But we were in Knoxville when we joined the show. So when Lawrence hired us, from that point on, it was the little Aldridge sisters from Knoxville, Tennessee.
That's
never
right.
Changed.
Now, did you come from a musical family?
Oh, yes.
Yes, we did. My father was very musical. The whole Aldridge clan was very musical. And he played every string instrument. His father taught him to play. He also sang, which is funny, with his younger brother. And they were asked to perform at Carnegie Hall. And they actually performed at Carnegie Hall when my father was 11 and my uncle was 9 in front of President Theodore Roosevelt. So that was a big deal for two little boys from the mountains of
amazing.
Western North Carolina.
It was amazing.
So the inevitable question, how did you get on the Lawrence Welk show?
I'll let you
oh, my gosh. My mother and father were, of course, fans of the Lawrence Welk show. And my mom was looking in the paper and happened to see that they were going to be performing in Nashville. So, I mean, we were teenagers pretty much at that time, but we were going on a date. And when we got in the car, our boyfriend said, well, where are we going to go tonight? We said, we're going to see Lawrence Welk, the concert in Nashville.
You can imagine how well that went over.
Not to mention Nashville is about 2.5 hours from where
right.
You know we live. So they were stunned, of course, and like, yeah, sure, right. And we're like, yeah, sure, right. We're going to go do this. So we got there, and you know, the tickets that we had weren't too expensive. So it was pretty much in the nosebleed section.
Right.
And when the show started, we started making our way down to go see Lawrence, leaving our dates cackling. They were just cracking up. And we got down to the bottom level, finally. And you know, Mary, we remember how they would have the curtains up on either
side. In arenas.
Yes,
they were drapes
in the arenas, right. And we started trying to get through there, and there was this, you know, like stage security guard. And he, it was like puppies, you know. He would go and, like, try to pick us up by the neck and, you know, put him on. And he did that. He did that two times. And then, as they say, by the grace of God.
And faith.
Unbelievable kismet. Lawrence just walked right out of that curtain.
And right in front of us.
I checked out where the guard was, and he was gone, you know, enough that I thought, can I get to Lawrence before, you know, he comes
back? He gets
out.
To us.
So the guard took a look at us. We looked at him, and it was like, and we went right to Lawrence and tugged on his coattail. And he turned around, and we'll never forget this. He said, how cute can you be?
That was the first line he ever spoke to us.
And then, of course, I started, you know, babbling. I know that's
which
hard
so
to believe.
Which is so unlike her.
Yeah. And started saying, we're the Aldridge sisters, and we want to sing on your show. You're going to love us. Please listen to us. And he was just adorable and said, you know, come back at the end of the show. So we made the trek back up the bleachers, and our dates were just, you know,
still
can
laughing,
we leave now? May we leave now? We're going, no, he wants us to audition at the end of the show, and they were in shock. So we did. We went backstage, but this was amazing. There was a line of people. I mean, people were like juggling monkeys. I mean, it was unbelievable. And so we stood in line for quite a while. And right when the line, we were supposed to, you know, be the next ones to see Lawrence. Lon Varnell came out and said, you know, boys and girls,
this is where the line stops.
We have to stop here because these folks have to get back to California.
Lon was Lawrence's promoter.
Oh, absolutely.
For all those years.
And Elvis's as well, I think.
Yes.
Road manager, I think. So we were, you know, just beside
devastated.
Ourselves with grief, you know. And Ken Dillo,
we got a plug
our
in
hero,
Ken, here.
Ken Dillo came over and said, you know, Lon, I know that Lawrence wants to see these girls again. We went into the dressing room. I started to get my guitar, and we were going to sing something. And he said, no, no, I want to hear the purity. I want to hear, you know, forget the guitar.
Acapella.
Acapella. So we sang a song that he had no idea what it was. It was an ABBA song called Nando, and he listened and he said, "You girls are very good, but I have such a show, and I've got 1 hour show, and I have too many people, and where would I put you?" But he reached in his pocket and he handed us his business card.
That was his first mistake.
Big mistake. And he said, "If you girls ever get to the Santa Monica area, come see me." Well, it was not 2 weeks before we had our tickets ready and we were off like a shot to Santa Monica. So we got to see him, you know, that time. But once again, he said, "We don't have any space on the show for you." So
the third time.
He was so sweet. It was, we wore a track in the sky. I mean, we'd
so
go
you
home.
So flew back and forth?
Back
yes,
and forth.
Back and forth.
And we, at the time, had jobs in these little lounges.
And we had already told them, "We're going to be on the show." So
that's how gutsy and crazy, crazy
yeah.
we were.
That's what youth will do. You know,
exactly.
You do a lot of things.
Yeah.
It paid off.
Ignorance is bliss.
Paid
oh,
off
yes.
on the third time.
The third time was hysterical.
It was
because
the charm.
Do you remember Julie Job? Of course you do.
Of course, in the office.
Oh, yeah. And when we went up there for the third time, we didn't realize this. We'd been auditioning this whole time, and the Gong Show had even called us and accepted. I think you said that that happened to you as well. So we decided, well, we're going to go up to, you know, the office once again. And the doors reminded me of the Wizard of Oz. It was like, you know, how intimidating that must have been. But we went through those doors, and Julie got this look on her face like, "Oh, no, here they are again. We're back." Yeah. So she called Margaret or someone in the back, and the next thing we knew, Lawrence came bursting through the door and said, "Girls, I've been trying to reach you all day. My daughter-in-law got her own act, and she's going away, and I have a spot maybe for you to do a guest spot." So
we went in, auditioned, and as luck would have it, the whole production staff was in a meeting.
Day.
Oh, man.
And it was just everything clicked. We went in, Mary Lou, we auditioned. They sat there very silently for a while.
We were
and
terrified
said,
at the end
Jim
of our
Hobson
song.
Jim Hobson said, "I think they're great, Lawrence. Let's put them on the show."
Now, you came on the show as a duo, but it wasn't long after that that you were teamed with the Otwell twins.
Right.
How did that happen?
Well, what happened first, we were hired first. We came on as a duo. Then the Otwells had sent a tape. They loved it, wanted them to come on.
It was not rejected.
Yes, that's right. They did a guest shot. And it was one of those things again, Mary Lou, where he just didn't have enough space, enough time for two separate duos.
And, of course, Guy and Rolna, you know,
right.
who can top
right.
that.
Of course.
So they put us together, and the fans loved it. You know, lots of great fan mail. And that was all wonderful. And we were happy, but I have to say this. What happened was it was the family name that worried us more than anything. We love the boys. But at first it was suggested that we be the brothers and the sisters. And that's where we said we can't do this. I mean, the family name was everything
of
to
course.
us.
And the boys finally.
And the
know,
boys felt the same
they,
way.
I was gonna say
you know how they were, and they used to call me Sheila.
Yeah.
Like, Sheila, get in there and tell him. Get in there and ask him if he can change our names back. We want our family name too.
Right. And,
which
and
is
I have
what
to
we
say
did.
That we went into Lawrence, and he was very understanding of that because let's face it, this was a family show. Family was important to him. He totally felt our
he
feelings.
He understood our plight.
Totally.
Yeah.
So that's when we became the Aldridge sisters and the Otwell.
Lawrence was sensitive to people's feelings.
Very.
Yes. Very.
Very.
So what did you do after the weekly series ended?
How much time you got?
How long is this interview again?
Well, like everything else in our very blessed life, when the show ended, because of our exposure from the Lawrence Welk Show, we became Don Rickles' opening act, Bob Hope's opening act.
George Burns.
George Burns was like the grandfather we never had. Wonderful. We worked with him for about 8 years on and off.
Really?
Uh-huh.
And,
that was incredible.
You know, none of those doors would have been open to us if it hadn't been for Mr. Welk.
Hee Haw, we did the Hee Haw show. Many, many things. We moved to Nashville right after the show ended. Did a lot of recording also, so.
We've been so lucky to have you. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Mary Lou. It's always great to see you.
It
always.
Is, and you look beautiful.
Thank you.
You look marvelous.
And thank you so much for being so warm and welcoming to all of us for all these years. As Lawrence Welk always said, keep a song in your heart.
The preceding program has been brought to you in part by...
Guess what, Grandma?